Now, News 8's weather on the 8s with meteorologist Joe Calhoun.
6:38. Do you remember March 10th? The reason I say that, it's the only 60 we have hit so far this spring. 60, I know, that wasn't even spring officially, right? Only 60-degree weather. Well, we may be seeing some more of that, folks. Not quite today. I think we get lower 50s. Start out sunny, cold, but I do think we see some high clouds come in, kind of filter out the sun a little later on. Not a bad day, though. Overnight tonight, a little light rain, especially south and east of Harrisburg. Try and pinpoint that for you coming up here in a second. And a little bit of rain. It could be around tomorrow morning, but it should clear out. And once it clears out, it'll be breezy, but it should be milder. Could get close to that 60-degree mark for tomorrow. Looking live over Lebanon right now. Yeah, pretty much a clear morning out there, but temperatures are cold. 23 degrees, clear, calm, and cold at last report. Most temperatures in the 20s, 26 in Gettysburg, 24 in Shamokin. Look at that, Landisburg's at 21, so State College, so is York. Some near record numbers out there this morning. A frosty, cold morning, no doubt about that. With clear skies, you don't expect to find anything on the radar, and we don't. But there are some clouds on our doorstep. These are just those high, wispy clouds. Again, they're going to filter out the sun. Here's where most of the precipitation is from the Tennessee Valley down through parts of the Florida Panhandle. That's going to start moving in our direction. High pressure right now is blocking it, but this storm starts to head eastbound. At the same time, so is this front coming in from the Great Lakes. And we think what will happen is that front will kind of block most of this precipitation as it comes down through the atmosphere. It starts to shove the precipitation off to the east. See how close it is? I think if you live south and east of 78 and 81, that line through parts of Gettysburg, Chambersburg, perhaps on the fringe of some light rain overnight tonight. But look at this. This is going through tomorrow morning and tomorrow afternoon. It is clearing out. High pressure building back in. Should give us another chilly night tomorrow night into Saturday morning. But then this front comes our way on Sunday. Ahead of it, pretty nice day, just some high-level clouds coming back in on Saturday. But all in all, the trend is up. Let me show you why. Here's the jet stream. You see this big dip? That's what's pumping that moisture in our direction. But it goes on by. And look, by Sunday, we're in this westerly flow of air. And by next week, predictors showing jet stream going well off to our north and west. This southerly flow could really start to warm up. We're not surprised me. We start seeing some 70s next week. 50s the next couple of days. Looks pretty nice. Could get 60 tomorrow. Not out of the question. A little light rain around tonight. Then it looks like a chance of some showers Sunday and Monday. But the trend is up in temperatures. Senators, Bowie Bay Sox tonight. Mostly cloudy. Clouds start coming in then. In the 50s for the first pitch, but back into the 40s. So you still want a jacket on.
Oh, yeah.
It's a little chilly.
Yeah.
Good to watch baseball in any weather, though.
Yeah. Makes you feel a little warmer, at least.
At least baseball. Yeah,
that's right.
Going the right way.
Yeah. All right,
hopefully.
Joe, thank you.